As you guys may know, recently I was discovering all kinds of possibilities of working with shape design, and my latest experiment is about using layers, or a lasso. In any case, it involves a lot of software-specific things, which always makes me a bit conscious. What if I have to switch the device or operating system and all kinds of stuff, you know? Will I be able to perform the same way in my Photoshop on Windows, sitting at home and everything? And while I wanted to give it a try, I remembered something that I promised to someone. Specifically, I promised Lucky Clan to make a video about their new version of Artstudio Pro. My favorite painting app on iPad. They released the version 3.0, I think like around New Year's. And I really wanted to make a video about it because it actually includes a new brush made by me. So we had Borodante brush before that works like this, and I added this Borodante Air. And it uses one interesting new feature. As you can see in the preview right here at the top, you can see that the brush stamp is really soft, and the brush stroke is actually pretty sharp. But what's interesting, it's not always sharp. If you press slightly and you use the brush in the blending mode, you can see how it's actually a soft brush. It has very soft edges, the way it is in the preview. But when we press harder, it gets a sharper shape. And that's because Lucky Clan watched one of my then recent videos about blending issues in many apps where the brush actually blends colors even when it's not touching that color when it's just getting really close. And you can see in here there's no issue like that. You can actually work on the very edges of objects and things remain clean, no pollution of the color with the red. And that's thanks to the new parameter added to the wetness section of the brush that is called flat hotspot. So this 50%, there was a bunch of experiments with it, but I think 50% in the end means that whatever the size of the brush you have, actual colors to blend with are being picked up from only the 50% smaller size in the center. So you can easily work on the edges, and blending colors will only happen when your vague center 50% actually cover those colors. So that lets you have a really wet brushwork while at the same time being really clean with no issues when you try to work around the edges of the character or something. So that's really cool. But another thing they added is in the stamp parameters. In here, there's contrast. I think contrast was here before, so you can actually manipulate the way your stamp looks at all without having to constantly resave new files with that. But what's really cool, in Dynamics, you have the control over contrast. So literally, if I press slightly, that contrast is not applied at all, it will be 0%. But when I press as hard as I can, it will get to the maximum of that 90% that I just set up in the contrast, which lets you have your brush really soft and letting you like blend colors together in a much more productive way, like getting those very fluffy gradients when you blend colors around. But when you press harder, you get a texturized sharp thing with interesting edges on the brush and all of that. Really cool. So I've been working on this brush for a little while, and with the latest version I painted this kind of thing. That's what happened while I was testing it, and it really feels great to work with it, so I highly recommend you guys give it a try with something like artistic like that. But then I thought, what about my whole new shape design approach where I only use this flat brush and everything? Can I at all work with a round blending brush? Like, how would that work, you know? Creating new layers and trying to define solid shapes in it, then work inside of their transparency. And how Artstudio overall would work with, you know, using so much layers and everything, especially since I'm really into like using specific shortcuts and everything. Well, yesterday I gave it a try with this quick study right here, and boy, it was a lot of fun. And I think Artstudio is one of, if not the only one, app on iPad that can give me the perfect combination of features to let me work like that. So I have two stages right here. This is what I started with, and pretty much you can see I worked with different defining the background, then adding the black silhouette of the of this woman. I don't know, she seems like she's from a movie or something. Then I started painting with the white brush, and what's interesting about all of it is that it's still a blending brush that can blend its own colors with transparency like this. And that's probably the best way to implement a blending brush for working in layers, to actually have it blend into transparency, and then you can go ahead and use all kinds of tricks with layers and everything on top of that. So that's exactly what I did. So I added a couple of details, I saved this just to show you guys how I started, and then I continued working, adding all kinds of details. So this was the shape I merged all together. Apparently I used the flesh colored brush to add some better shapes to the face in here, which turned out pretty well. And yeah, inside of it I was just adding layers and working with separate shapes, while it all being a very wet and expressive texturized brushwork with a lot of blending and everything, all of this is simply divided into layers with the using of the locked transparency and clip masking and all of that. So the same thing going on. I would maybe have even a better time if I would have the brush squished, because whenever I work with like details inside, like with this area, right? So inside of the white shape of this strip of cloth, these details, they're really like, they look really fast and not really well defined. And if I would be using the flat brush for that, I would be able to easily define the good planes and all that. But one way to work around it, the way many artists work, is that you choose a much smaller brush and you sort of do the trick of defining your shapes with a smaller scratching brushwork like this. Look at this beautiful thing. I'm like working at the very edge of this white shape, and it's not being polluted with the black color right next to it. So it only starts blending when you get much closer, which is another thing that really helps you define shapes much better, even though this is a heavily blending brush and all of that. Here I am, like, shaping up from the black side. I'm even pressing very slightly, so it's actually very blending. And yeah, this is the way I like to have my layout. On the left, I have a little strip for multitasking and using any kind of references I want, in this case, the main reference. On the right, I have layers that you can easily, like, whenever you summon them, like, if you don't touch it, it disappears the way it does in Procreate or whatever, but then you can just wiggle it around and then it will stay and you can use it and actually see what you're doing with your layers. That's really useful and like really necessary. I was so bummed out when Procreate added the feature of having your like color palette stick around on the screen and not disappear, but didn't do that for the layers. It's like, why? So literally, it's much harder to work with layers in Procreate just for that one reason. You don't see what you're doing. You have to open it every time. Even if you use some kind of shortcuts, which you can't customize in Procreate. In here, you can customize everything by going into interface, keyboard shortcuts. And in here, it's like literally Photoshop on desktop. You have all kinds of settings. And so I get to create a new layer, I get to toggle the clipping mask, and I get to lock the transparency. All of the things I ever need, as well as, of course, duplicating a layer or something. So you have the full package, like literally there is no difference for me between working in Artstudio on iPad or with Photoshop on desktop. It literally has all the features involved in this kind of process. Same as the lasso, I was using it sometimes, like if I can see that maybe the hair is a bit too long or something, I will select this part real quick, Control T, and then go ahead and manipulate the height of this layer, nudge it around by using the arrow keys, and there you go. Quick manipulations, nothing is stopping you. Editing things and everything, it was a lot of fun. And yeah, one thing that was really exciting to me is that on top of whatever I do in Photoshop, this is also a brush with flat blending that is completely absent. Oh my god, this is a horror. Completely absent from Photoshop, you can't have this kind of brush. So it kind of expands the way, like, the art styles you can have by using layers and everything, because I think it's a pretty interesting combination where you use layers and maybe lasso, you know, all that kind of stuff, while at the same time you're using the brush that's actually blending colors around. That's pretty dope. This is so trippy. So yeah, I had quite a good time working with all this yesterday. I also wanted to talk a little bit about this little note I did yesterday, which was a part of an issue while also a bit of a thought on improving further with the whole brushwork idea and shape design and stuff like that. Like, it's interesting where, especially with this blending brush, I noticed sometimes I wanna use the sharp and strong brushwork, like press hard and define edges of certain shapes. But then inside of them, I would wanna use the blending brush to show certain gradients or some kind of texturized variations. And that's like texture instead of a shape. And I noticed that's like two things you kinda work with and something you should be deciding on early on when you start blocking things in. Like, where's that contrast is gonna be going on, where you need to define a strong shape, while inside of those shapes, you work with more of like a texture without defining strong. Like, the area of lost edges can be pretty much the area of the texture, which is really interesting because it lets you stylize things in a very interesting fashion. I kind of want to give it a try a little bit with the outfit, like with this cloth in here. I want to maybe define it a bit more separately in terms of high contrast elements. And here I defined this and this, while in reality I don't really have that segregation. It looks kind of messy. And I was thinking to add that today and see how I can, by blocking two separate high contrast groups and working inside of them with more expressive details, just blending around, will it actually work out very nicely? Which is, I think it will. So we'll see what I can do with that, but to keep this video short, this was pretty much all I wanted to talk about. This way of working with shapes in layers, actually on iPad, it totally works if you use a proper software for that. The video is not sponsored or anything, I just thought it would make a good short video to share my thoughts on how to work in a different environment at all, if it's possible or not. Like, these things, they get really software specific and I usually don't like it. But generally I notice that if whenever you use tools that are provided in Photoshop, you can probably find an app that's kind of repeating them, and Artstudio is doing a great job in specifically doing everything Photoshop does exactly the same way and then just building on top of it. So you can really apply this kind of workflows even on iPad. So yeah, tell me what you think. Thank you guys for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!